Hello everyone. This video we're going to look at basic authentication and we're going to be using Flask. Let me just do a demo first of what we're actually going to be building. The first thing we're going to be doing is creating an app, port 5000 with Flask, and it will be taking two arguments, which will be password and the username. So we're going to make sure the user is authenticated so that they can access the particular page. Username, admin, password is password. We've successfully logged in. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is our imports. We'll do from Flask, lowercase Flask, import Flask, and also request, no S, remember. So this is not the same as import requests, which you might otherwise use and will be using later on. I'm also going to use from functools. We're going to use wrap. What that does is it actually protects your doc strings if you're using a wrapper. So it's optional. You don't have to use it, but I'm just using it for good practice. And then as usual, app equals and then Flask, capital F. A function to we want one to check our authorization, but let's actually just write them and then we'll just put pass by them. So check auth for that function, we want to pass in a username and password. So it's checking what you pass in. Okay. Next we want to enforce the authorization, so we want to return unauthorized if it's not working. So we'll do def, and then this is where we use the wrapper. So you don't have to do this, but it's just, it protects, it keeps the doc strings of the original function. So and then inside that we'll put the actual function, which will be decorated. Wrapped function decorated, and then we're going to pass in args and the keyword arguments args. Hope if I can type properly. And then we need to say auth equals, then this is where we use request. Authorization. If auth is not true, if not auth, or not check auth, we'll pass in, we want the auth name, and the auth password. Then we will return an authorize. The 401 error. Otherwise, we'll return the actual args and the keyword args. And then at the end, we return the decorated function. Then decorated. Okay, so that was kind of the tricky bit. Next, we will just set up the routes, which is fairly standard behavior for Flask. So okay, let's complete our check auth function. All that actually needs to do is just return username equals username and password equals password. Let's do it 1, 2, 3. Sometimes it gets, let's call that admin as well. Okay, so we now check if the username and password are correct with what the user has entered. So check auth, that takes what the user's entered, and then returns username equals admin, returns password equals password, if that's true. So the next thing to do is actually start using these in some routes. So with Flask, you have app.root, and then you specify your route that you want to protect. So protected. And then you actually have to, if you want to protect it, then you use the function requires auth, which we've just written. And then you actually specify a function. So all we've done so far is just protect it. And then we actually, now we write the function, which actually does something, which returns a message. You have successfully logged in. Okay, so far so good. The other thing we'll do is we will just create a default home route, which is basically an unprotected route, which we'll call the function home. Good practice to call the function after the route. So the route and the function name need to match, really, for it to be nice and readable. So then we'll say, welcome to my Flask app. Then the final thing to do, so as you can see here, we need to put in app.root. And then we just put /. I think that's the same on Windows. Pretty sure. Next, we actually want to put in the code to let it run. So if thunder name equals thunder main, then you do app.run. That's the simplest way to. And double equals. And that's all good. So if we run that code, welcome to my Flask app. So far, so good. That was just going to home. So what we want to do now is just write some Python code which tests the protected route. Okay, so now we want to go ahead and write our code to test our Flask app. So first thing we'll do is import. Note the difference, import requests with the S on the end. From, so it's a different module to the request that we had in the app was not the same as this. Requests. So this is where we're going to use auth with the auth method from requests. Then import HTTP basic auth. That will allow us to pass the username and password as authentication parameters. URL equals, this is the URL of the protected route that we want to test. So we'll be testing HTTP OS 1.2. It's just going to be running locally for our test example. Port 5000, and the protected route was called protected. Let's say prompts for credentials. Now we want to set variables called username equal, and then we'll get the input from the user. So that's just the prompts that asking the user to put in the username, and then next we'll do the same for the password. Equals input password. Okay, so then we've got the parameters, the username and password, which we can then send with our request. So then we will say, let's just say send get request with basic authentication response. So our response will be equal to requests.get, and then we pass it the URL, and this is where we specify authentication or auth equals HTTP basic auth. And then inside that, we pass in username and password variables. So that's attempting to log in for us. If our username and password are correct, let's check. Check the response code. So we either want a 200 or something else. So if response.status code equals 200, so we've got a successful login. Print quest successful. And also we'll print the body, so we'll do print response body, which will be response text. If we've sent the wrong password, then we just want to check. We want to know that it was the wrong password, so then we'll just pass the message to the user. Quest failed with status code, and then we'll just pass back the response status code. Okay, and then we'll also just print an error message as well, which will be the response text. You see here, you've got lots of options. So you could pass back other things. You could pass back the response headers, encoding, raw, status quo, text, URL, etc. So all of those are available to you. We just want to pass back the text. Okay, so that looks all right. Let's test it, if we test it now, we should find that we get... Okay. Wrong window. So let's start again from scratch. If I can come back up to the top window. So clear. The reason I've got two windows is because I need one to run Flask. So we'll do Python. app.py in the top one to get the server running. And then down below, we'll do Python lc7.py. So that's going to be for a username. So me, password, pass. And it knows it's incorrect. And if I can remember what I called the username and password, we'll try and get a successful one. So I called it, did I call it admin? And password 123. No, so I need to go and check. Okay, I had an error which I fixed, so I've just renamed this back to protected. The actual function which will run when app.root tries to go to protected. So if we attempt to run the code, I need to bring up Flask app, which would be Python. app.py, and then let's open another window and we'll just do Python lc7.py admin password. There we go, successful response. And let me just show you, there we go, get protected 200. let's make these run side by side, shall we? So you just see, we run it again. Okay, that's good. Then if we run it, we have the bad password. Unauthorized. So hopefully that's been a good quick intro to Flask and how to secure a root. There's also other methods such as login and so on, but we won't go into those here. Thank you for watching.